KSBW High School Playbook Blitz.
One speaks for all. Welcome to week number one of High School Playbook Blitz. We'll be here every Friday night from now until Thanksgiving with scores and highlights from the high school games in the area. All the games, of course, in the first couple of weeks, with the exception of one or two, they're non-league games. And tonight we begin week number one at the home of the Pacific Grove Breakers. PG opening up their season at Cowan Stadium against Watsonville High. Right here, solid 20-yard run by Pacific Grove's Jason Leach. Down in the territory there, the Wildcats. Then it's Jake Speed takes it in for the breaker touchdown. Jake Speed, I got a feeling we're going to say this name a lot this season. He was impressive tonight. Later, Jake Speed going to take the short pass and turn it into a long touchdown. He's caught it, breaks a couple tackles, gone. Nice run after the catch. 31 yards after the catch. PG up by two scores, and they go on to win it big time. Pacific Grove over Watsonville. 47-6, the final for Pacific Grove. Way to go, Breakers. Now let's head to Santa Cruz. Santa Cruz High against Pajaro Valley. Santa Cruz in his dark burgundy uniform. And right here for Santa Cruz, you're going to see a little screen pass here. Tyler Schenck to Dale Stoller. Both these guys played very well tonight. Big game here for the Cardinals and number six, Dale Stoller. Then, check out the effort here by the running back coming up right here. He's going to sweep the left side. I think it's Stoller again. Actually, this is Ashton Davis. He's going to stick it in. Great effort right there. Touchdown, Santa Cruz. But later, it was Stoller. I was thinking a play ahead. As Stoller goes again, this time 40 yards for the Cardinal touchdown. Great start to the season for the Cardinals of Santa Cruz. They come out on top tonight, 43-21 over Pajaro Valley in this non-league game. Cardinals looking good. Next stop, home of the Seaside Spartans. Seaside High tonight, tough task, taking on Skyline High of Oakland. Skyline, the team in the white tops and gray pants. And it's Seaside High on the attack here. Little pitch out there. Chris Evans, a junior quarterback, looked good, except this play, he has his pass intercepted. Nice play by the Skyline linebacker, takes it back. But later, you know, early in the game, little jitters, maybe later, Evans looks much, much better here. He's on the money, big gain here. Ron Turner, 46 yards on the play here for Seaside High School. And then we're going to see Evans find Cordell Reed in the end zone. He had a couple of TDs in the game. Seaside looking good after the score. Fine return by the Skyline kick returner here. He's going to make a nice return, but they never would reach the end zone against a tough Seaside defense. And Seaside High, despite this play, comes away with a shutout win. 24-0, Seaside the winner tonight. Seaside next week will take on Aptos High. Greenfield Bruins tonight. There's some of the fans in Greenfield. They're home against St. Francis Central Coast Catholic of Watsonville. Greenfield in the green here. Rudy Amesqua on the keeper for six. I'm going to say that name again and again. Bruins get another quick six. Later, it's Rudy Amesqua. I hope the Amesqua family is watching tonight there in Greenfield, because your guy had a great game. Here he is. It's another quarterback keeper coming up shortly by Rudy Amesqua. And no, we're not on the Amesqua payroll. He just had a really great game while our cameras were there. Rudy Amesqua looked really sharp. But later, the Sharks of St. Francis made a great comeback, not showing him. And the final score, 28-27. St. Francis, Central Coast Catholic with a come-from-behind win over Rudy Amesqua tonight in South Monterey County. Let's go Soledad Aztecs against Alisal High from Salinas. There's Soledad. Soledad got some new uniforms this year. How about a 75-yard quarterback keeper right here? Number 8 of Soledad gets tipped. I'd like to tell you his name, but Soledad has yet to supply us with the roster. We need the roster so we can supply the name of the man who made that run and the guy who scored this touchdown. It's early in the season. We understand. Neither team yet. Heck, the other team, Alisal, they haven't given us a roster either. Can't say the names of the kids if we don't know what it is. Great catch here. Bottom line in this game, Soledad beats Alisal. 36-16 is the score. 36-16 is the score. Now let's head up the road, Highway 101 to Gilroy. It's Gilroy and Live Oak, two schools just a few miles apart but in different leagues. Playing tonight at Jeff Garcia Stadium there in Gilroy. Live Oak now plays in the Blossom Valley League, and they got some talent. Trevor Bearden on the first play from scrimmage. 70-yard touchdown. First play from scrimmage right up the middle. Great job by the defensive line. Up next, how about a nice play by the Gilroy High defense? Interception, Bubba Lara. This is the name we're going to hear this year. Bubba Lara, big player for the Gilroy Mustangs. Takes it off deep into Live Oak territory. Mustangs, nice pass here. David Munoz and a great catch. Bubba Lara, just short of the end zone, though. Just short of the end zone. Doesn't matter. Brandon Boyd busts over. Gilroy took the lead. Later, it's another score for the Live Oak Acorns. It's Eric Orndorff to Cole Griffin here. Touchdown. By the way, you look at the seats on the other end of the stadium there in Gilroy. They're totally empty. That's because that part of the stadium is condemned right now. They're going to fix it. 52-41, Live Oak will win. Or 52-41, Live Oak wins. Next week, Gilroy will play Sobrado. Okay, our next stop, Gonzales. How do I know? That's how. The distinctive ball of the city of Gonzales. Gonzales home against the Alvarez Eagles tonight. Alvarez in the white and here. Quarterback Cesar Ramirez has his pass intercepted by Gonzales High on the defense. That would lead to a touchdown for the Spartans. Little pass here, quarterback to running back. Roster needed. Check out this play by the Alvarez quarterback, Cesar Ramirez. Cesar Ramirez kind of reminds me of Randall Cunningham on this play. Am I dating myself there? I am. Anybody remember Randall Cunningham? He looked like this. What an effort. Scrambling, rambling. Great job, Cesar Ramirez, all the way down to the 3-yard line. A couple plays later, Paul Salinas takes it into the end zone for the Eagles of Alvarez. Game would end in favor of the Alvarez Eagles, and Alvarez coach David Bottom, congratulations, he gets a win, first time out. They hadn't won in a long time, 56-13, the final. Alvarez. Now let's go to the old scoreboard. What do you say? SoCal a winner over King City, 27-13 in that one. Ensenal downs Aptos. Game-winning field goal, 13-10. Also, Hollister over Pioneer, 31-14. Scotts Valley routes Evergreen, 41-3. Christopher High of Gilroy wins over Sobrado, 36-16. Monta Vista Christian of Watsonville, they beat Del Mar, 42-0. Several games Saturday, including the big doubleheader to New Rabobank Stadium. New Rabobank Stadium tomorrow. Salinas, North Salinas, 4:30 in the afternoon. That's followed by Palma High and Carmel at 7. For more on high school football and all the other games, news, weather, everything else, go to KSBW.com. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back with more after this.